In the last few videos, I've been talking about feedback and whether it's positive or negative and what homeostasis is and what a feedback loop is. And what I want to do now is get into some really important real-world thinking, and that is to answer the question, how can we visualize feedback loops within the human body? Now, before we start visualizing, I need you to remember a couple things. First of all, remember that every feedback loop, when it's in operation, is going to be dealing with two changes in the variable in question. There's going to be the initial change that activates it, the change caused by the external environment or by some other factor within the body. And that initial change is called a stimulus. And then the feedback loop is going to produce a change in that variable, and that's called the response. You have to remember, the stimulus and the response will both be changes in the same variable. So if we're talking about an initial change in blood pressure as the stimulus, then whatever the response is, it has to also be a change in blood pressure. So let's just diagram this to get us started. We have our physiological variable, and it's going to change. And that initial change is called the stimulus. The stimulus is detected by a receptor in the body. The receptor is going to then communicate with a control center. The control center is going to communicate with an effector organ, and the effector organ is going to, from its name, produce an effect. An effect that is going to result in a change in that same physiological variable we started with. And that change in that variable is called the response. This is a nice simple diagram that you can use to visualize feedback loops. But what I'd like to do is push this a bit farther. But before we do, I got to reiterate, the stimulus is the change in the physiological variable. It's not the reason the variable changed, it's the change itself. So, for example, if you get scared, your blood pressure is going to rise. But the stimulus isn't being scared. That's not the stimulus. You don't have scare receptors in your body. You have what are called baroreceptors that monitor blood pressure. The stimulus is the increased blood pressure. There's lots of ways we can respond, but at the end, the response physiologically is the change in the same variable we started with. It's not the mechanism. In other words, if we need to increase your blood pressure, we could do that by raising your heart rate. But the increased heart rate isn't the response. It's the increased blood pressure that results. Increased heart rate is the mechanism by which the effector produces the response, which is the increase in blood pressure. Now, I talk more about this in my classes, but really be aware the stimulus and response are changes in the variable, not why the variable changes, not how the variable changes, but the change itself. That's what matters. So I want to talk through two simple examples. The first one involves your body temperature on a hot day. This is going to be very similar to the house example from the last video. Okay, your body temperature is going to increase when you go outside on a hot day. If it's hot enough, heat's either not leaving your body fast enough or possibly even entering it, so your body temperature rises. Thermoreceptors in your body detect that change in body temperature. They detect that increase, and they communicate with what's called the hypothalamic thermostat. Hypothalamus in the brain is what sets body temperature, and it determines from input from the thermoreceptors that temperature's too high. And so the hypothalamic thermostat responds by communicating with what are called eccrine sweat glands. These glands produce sweat on the surface of the skin. As that sweat evaporates, it has a cooling effect on the surface of the body, facilitating a heat transfer out of the body and thereby decreasing body temperature. There's one example. Let's do another one really quickly. Let's talk about what happens to your blood pressure when you've been sitting for a while, like in class, and then you stand too quickly. Your blood pressure, when you stand quickly after having been sitting for a long period of time, will drop. That decrease in blood pressure is detected by what are called baroreceptors. These are pressure receptors, and there's lots of baroreceptors in the body, but I want to focus here on the baroreceptors in the carotid arteries, which take blood to the brain. Those baroreceptors detect that drop in blood pressure and communicate with the cardioregulatory center of the medulla oblongata in the brain. This is the part of the brain that oversees cardiac function, heart function. And in this circumstance, we need to raise blood pressure after it's dropped. So the cardioregulatory center communicates with the heart and directs cardiac muscle within the heart to contract more often, thereby increasing heart rate and thereby increasing blood pressure. We responded to a decrease in blood pressure by producing an increase. And notice, when I take this figure, I can just change it back into that generic one I started with. And there is your framework for homeostasis in the human body.